Hello viewers, today I am going to demonstrate you a surgical video on fracture fixation of the capitellum. Capitellum is a small bone which is present at the lower end of your arm bone and it forms the elbow joint. And today's surgery is a demonstration of how we fix this fractures. So there is a classification system of Bryan and Murray which classifies them into type 1 to type 4. If you look at here, this looks like a typical type 1 fracture. However, if you look at the oblique view or on this lateral view, you see this double density. So one density here and one density there. That tells that this is not only a fracture of capitellum, but it has also taken bit of the trochlea, and that makes it a type 4 injury. So our patient is now anesthetized. We have used tourniquet. This is on arm table. Your landmark is lateral epicondyle, radial head. This is lateral supracondylar ridge. So your incision is over the lateral supracondylar ridge where it starts up to 2 cm distal to where your radial head is. And you center your incision directly over the lateral epicondyle. So we'll start with this incision. I will just try to take a smaller incision. And let's see if it suffices. If necessary, you can always extend it. So just do your superficial skin incision. And do the superficial dissection. So we have done our skin and subcutaneous tissue dissection. I'm just going to raise flaps, both sides. And never try to grab the skin, just lift the skin. You don't want to cause any unnecessary trauma. So I'm just using my forceps to lift. So now we have raised both flaps. This is the lateral epicondyle. So in terms of your approach, the proximal approach is like a direct lateral approach, which is over the supracondylar ridge between flexor and extensor muscles. Distally, it is like a typical Cocker approach between anconeus and extensor carpulnaris. So I'm not going to go through the approach, but all we need to do is combination of both approach. Direct lateral approach proximally and Cocker approach distally, and raise one single flap. So now I'm starting my proximal dissection directly over the lateral epicondyle. And you want to raise it as one thick flap. So let's raise here first. Is the incisor, please? Stay close to the bone and raise it as one single flap. You just want to raise it as one single flap. So this is our flap over the supracondylar ridge. And now I'm going to make my incision distally. And then combine this incision as one. And during the dissection, keep your arm pronated so that radial nerve is away from the surgical field. So once I have raised my flap, I will join you. So now, in terms of our proximal dissection over lateral epicondyle, this is common extensors which is being lifted along with bit of the anterior capsule. So I'm just going to just stay close to the bone and then start dissecting this anterior capsule along with these common extensors. And here, when you combine with the same anconeus distal Cocker approach, you will start seeing the radial head.
and you can start seeing it now here. You can start seeing that the radial head is coming in the visual field. Just lift it as one single flap. So once I have raised this flap, I'll join you. So once I have raised this flap, that includes common extensors as well as some part of the capsule, I have started seeing capitellum. Now there is some fibrosis because this injury is 15 days old. It's not a fresh fracture. If it was a fresh fracture, I won't see this scarring. So I've just released a bit of the scarring and you can start seeing the capitellum here. And it has come from this area. So we just need to identify this and then try to reduce it and fix it. But before that, we need to have a good exposure. So I'm just going to continue raising the flap of my Cocker approach and then I will come back and join. So now you can see this one big chunk, that is capitellum, that is part of the trochlea, and that was the reason you were seeing that double shadow. So this is not a type 1, this is a type 4 injury. Now this is all scarred up because it's 15 days old, and if I put my finger, this is all, margins are all smooth. So I'm just going to use a curette to freshen the edges, both of the humerus, anterior surface and the posterior surface of trochlea and capitellum, and then I will join you back. So now I have scraped out the anterior surface of the humerus. Now even behind you can see this is all smoothened up. So I'm just going to freshen it up with a curette till that membrane that has been formed in these 15 days is gone. And then our next step will be to try to give it a good wash and try to reduce it and secure it with few K-wires and then fix with a headless screw. So I hope you don't have to deal with these old fractures, and this is extremely uncommon in developed countries. However, it is not unusual to find old fractures in developing world. So I've just scraped it and it looks pretty good, and if you look at behind, and this is all freshened up. So it's extremely important that you freshen up both the fracture edges before you attempt any reduction. Now this is 2 weeks old. It will be a bit of a struggle to reduce it anatomically, but hopefully we should manage. So one useful tip is that when you're doing this operation, as I stressed before, keep the arm pronated and don't put any retractors, especially Hohmann retractors like this, across the radial neck, because then you risk injuring or causing compressive neuropathy of posterior interosseous nerve. So avoid using any retractors over the radial neck. So now we should reduce it and fix it with few wires. So by just applying some traction and directly manipulating the fracture and then reducing, we have managed to reduce. Now you can see the radial head is nicely articulating and the capitellum looks well fixed. Before you proceed on to the fixation, just make sure that you take an appropriate x-rays to ensure that this is reduced anatomically. So we're just going to check AP and lateral on our C-arm. So now we have checked the position on C-arm, both on AP and lateral, it looks pretty good. And if you look here, even though this whole lateral soft tissue is open, this is very stable inherently. I'm doing full pronation, full supination, full flexion, full extension, and this fracture is now stable. And this is due to compressive force of the radial head. Now next step will be just putting 2 K-wires and 2 headless screws of appropriate size so that you can secure this fracture and start mobilization from day one. So I passed the first wire, now I'm just passing the second wire. And this is the 2 wires that we have passed. And then we are just going to use 2 headless screw of appropriate size to fix this. We have checked it in C-arm as well and it looks pretty good. So after passing the wire, I'm just using the drill. Now I can feel the second cortex. So now we have drilled it, so we are going to use and headless screw and buried under the articular surface. So I'm just going to put the screw. So now we have put the first headless screw of appropriate size. So we are going to repeat the process and put the second headless screw and then start our closure after checking the position in CR. So now we are passing the second screw. And you have to ensure that this is buried under the articular surface. You don't want to leave it proud, otherwise it causes pain and early wear and tear of the joint. So this looks pretty deep. Just going to take the wire off. And then if you see here, it's nice and solid. There is no reason why we can't start mobilizing straight away. So now we have checked the position of our screw both on AP and lateral view, and it looks pretty anatomical. So excellent results. Now it's just a matter of closure. So now we have fixed, we are ready for closure. Now one thing I forgot to tell is that if this is the lateral epicondyle, keep your dissection in the anterior half. You don't want to be going posteriorly and causing any damage to this posterior structures, that is the lateral ulna collateral ligament, that can cause instability in future. So just stay in the anterior half, don't go posterior, leave these structures alone. So now next step will be to just give it a good wash with the saline to remove all debris which has been created due to trauma and which can also be created while you are putting the screw. So just give a good wash and wash out all small bony bits before the closure. So once you are about to close, you have to appreciate this annular ligament. The white sheet that you can see, just take this retractor off, is the annular ligament which is dissected. So you just want to reconstruct it. So I always put my first stitch here. This is the radial aspect of the annular ligament, and this is the rest of the annular ligament. So use your first stitch and tie it together, and then you can start closing as a layer, both proximally as well as distally. So as I said before, this first stitch coming towards the annular ligament, and I use a Vicryl, and that is my first stitch to reconstruct the annular ligament. And once you have done that, the rest all will fall in place. As I say in most of my videos, the most important part of any operation is, of course, good dissection, but meticulous closure. If you don't close well, then your results will never be good. If you want to be a good surgeon, your dissection has to be very good, and whatever you have dissected, you have to reconstruct it back to its original. So I have put two stitches, one across the annular ligament, one just slightly proximal to it, and I just run a continuous layer. And this is a site of the muscle, so you don't want to strangle the muscle, so just take epimysium just to approximate it, and no deeper than epimysium. So just give good time for closure, don't rush. I see most surgeons, they fix the fracture and they leave their most junior team to close. And of course, if you have trained them well before, then it's fine. Otherwise, stay till the end, ensure that you have done a good closure, because a bad closure will most definitely spoil, or can spoil, a very good operation. This is my last stitch, so this is capsule closed along with the common extensors, and the next layer will be just subcutaneous fat and routine closure. So now this is our skin closed. Preoperatively, I could bend, flex only up to here, and there was a mechanical block. Now you can see full flexion, full extension, full supination and full pronation. So we're just going to put a non-adherent dressing, pressure dressing for 48 hours, and start mobilization of his elbow straight away as soon as he wakes up. So viewers, this was a surgical video of a capitellum fracture along with the fracture of the trochlea. This is an uncommon injury, and a lot of surgeons, they find this procedure quite daunting. However, I hope after watching this video, you should be able to do this procedure, as it is pretty straightforward. Thank you for watching this video. Do subscribe to our channel and do share this video.